Polycystic Ovarian Syndrome, or PCOS, is probably the most common health topic request that I get here at Stuff Mom Never Told You, so it's high time I'm making a video about it. First up, let's just define what polycystic ovarian syndrome is and the kind of symptoms that it produces. Simply put, polycystic ovarian syndrome is a metabolic disorder resulting in hormone imbalances that create a variety of both internal and externally visible symptoms. Its diagnosis is dependent on something called the Rotterdam criteria. A patient has to exhibit 2 out of 3 of the following conditions: elevated levels of androgens or male sex hormones, which could result in symptoms such as excessive hairiness, acne, and or male pattern balding. The absence or irregularity of menstrual cycles, which may or may not be accompanied by intermittent prolonged heavy periods. 12 or more pearl-like follicular cysts on the ovaries. PCOS can also lead to additional physical symptoms, such as infertility, obesity, an elevated risk for diabetes, heart disease, and uterine cancer, as well as psychological symptoms like anxiety, depression, and eating disorders. In other words, PCOS is no fun. And fact number one, it is highly common. In fact, it is one of the most common disorders of biological females of reproductive age, impacting up to 10% of the female population. And in fact, I've seen estimates as high as 21%. Fact number two, it's hereditary. Researchers are still trying to figure out exactly what the genetic link might be, but they know that it runs in families. PCOS doesn't just directly affect biologically female people. It can also affect both cis and trans men. Which leads me to fact number three, that up to 70% of people with polycystic ovary syndrome are undiagnosed. One study I looked at found that it took an average of 4 different doctors to accurately diagnose people with PCOS. On the one hand, that difficulty of diagnosis might have to do with how these symptoms might indicate things other than PCOS. But on the other hand, historically, it's taken a long time for doctors to actually take these kinds of symptoms seriously, instead of just telling women coming in complaining of acne and bad periods to just go home and stop being so hysterical. And before I get into PCOS treatment, I wanted to offer fact number 4, which can provide a little deeper insight into just how confounding of a medical condition this can be, because, get this, polycystic ovary syndrome might not actually produce multiple cysts on your ovaries. Hence, with the Rotterdam criteria, you only need 2 out of 3 conditions. Even the medical language used to describe this disorder can be misleading and confusing and is probably in need of an update. But the good news, according to fact number 5, is that PCOS is treatable. Right now, there is no cure. However, there are combination medication and lifestyle options that have been shown to radically improve the symptoms. And I know that there are lots of online resources out there, particularly of people with PCOS writing about their diets and exercise tips. So if you know of any of these, please offer them below in the comments. Speaking of comments, I want to hear from you. Are you someone dealing with PCOS? Do these symptoms sound familiar? How do you deal? What has been your experience getting or not getting a diagnosis? Let me know in the comments below, and I will also link to more resources so you can learn more about polycystic ovary syndrome. Bye, everybody. These are my kisses. Air kisses for everyone. Do 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 do.